Jared Oblige for MIAASports.net. We're at Boys Latin today. Pre-game interview, Butch Maisel, longtime teacher here and longtime coach. Now he's helping his son with the baseball team. There's been some transition, and it's also a legacy of history here. Your grandfather was Fritz Maisel, right?
Fritz Maisel, who played for the Yankees, stolen base leader, beat Ty Cobb 1 year in the American League, and had the Yankees stolen base record until Ricky Henderson broke it.
Now, played for the old International League Orioles.
Played for them. He was the captain of the International League Orioles that won 7 straight pennants, and then went on to be the manager for several years and a scout. He was associated with the Orioles for over 50 years.
Did he have some time with the Yankees?
He had 4 years with the Yankees, and they stole him for Home Run Baker. Good trade, and he went to the St. Louis Browns, and my grandmother didn't like it in St. Louis, and they moved back to Baltimore.
50 years in baseball.
Actually, probably a little more than that. Yeah.
Now, your legacy here includes you're an assistant coach of soccer, football, and ice hockey. Now, with baseball, your son Chris is now the head baseball coach. So, does he really understand this baseball tradition all the way down from Fritz?
Oh, yeah. We have all the family memorabilia at the house, and he knows every bit of it. In fact, in the movie that just came out, The Forgotten Birds, Chris wore my father's uniform from the 1931 team when he was the bat boy as the promo for the video, and actually got to hit a ball with my grandfather's bat.
Any favorite Fritz stories you can recall, like any interaction with Babe Ruth, Lou Gehrig, or any old greats?
Yeah, probably the best one was with Ty Cobb. Everybody thought Ty Cobb was a grouchy old guy, but he and my grandfather were really good friends, even though my grandfather beat him for the stolen base record. And before games, when they would play Detroit, they actually made a pact. They would sit on the opposing dugouts and stare at each other, filing their cleats as if they were going to spike each other, and it was all for show. They loved each other, actually, but they did it for the crowd.
Great stories. I'm glad I'm here today to get some insight on your family history, the family tree. And Chris, your son, is now the head baseball coach, and he's the great-grandson of legendary Fritz Maisel.
And a four-year starter.
And before we conclude, what about Bob Maisel? Tell me how he fit in this.
Well, Bob Maisel's my uncle. He was a longtime sports editor for the Morning Sun and was the head beat writer, I guess you could say, for the Orioles for many, many years. Good friends with all the old-timers, especially with Jim Palmer, Brooks Robinson, that crowd. And he should be here for the day we dedicate the field. And we're trying to get Brooks Robinson, we hope, but my uncle will definitely be here for that to see the tradition.
The MIAA this year has a lot of Oriole connections. We got Ian Hendricks, the son of Elrod Coach McDonough. We got Larry Sheets coming over here today with Gilman to play you guys. He'll probably have Cal helping him this season. We got Jimmy Crowley coaching at Loyola. And we got a famous Maisel here, a couple famous Maisels standing on the field.
And we had a Bordick 2 years ago.
Right, Mike Bordick, he's back with the Orioles again.
And we hope to have him help us out if he can.
Terrific. Butch, thanks for coming on with us, and good luck today and this season.
All right, thanks a lot.